No way. Check it out, guys. iMac G3 yet again. This is my second iMac G3. But you know what? I've got a feeling that this one's gonna work. And I'm gonna give it the first test live on camera. So, before I press that power button, let's just take a look at the iMac. We're gonna take a real quick look at it. Up here it says, iMac OS 10 10.2, memory 256 megabyte, 500 megahertz PowerPC G3. So that's what it says up there. Whether that's accurate or not is another thing. We have a Pro keyboard, and if this is the original keyboard that came with it, which is highly likely because he only had one Mac, and then this leads me to believe that this is one of the later models, sort of 2000-ish, because they started shipping with the Pro keyboard and mouse. He didn't have the mouse, so I've just plugged in one of my random mice that I had in a drawer. Coming round here, sorry if I make you feel slightly sick by moving the camera like this, but you can see that it's the FireWire model. It's got FireWire directly in the side there. And also, if I just come round here, sorry about the non-prepared video. I don't know if you'll be able to see this up there. This is just a guess, but there is indeed a VGA port underneath the iMac. So I got this for £35, which is a pretty good price, not too bad at all. But it came with a few things. Let's just look in this bag here. It came with this really bad Logitech mouse. Microsoft Office for Mac, which is really cool. This is the 2004 version here, but it's a copy. iMac in Easy Steps, one of these books. Some people like these kind of books. Very cool. We have some kind of Mac speech thing. It's just a headset in here. Not too sure, really. And here we have some discs. And now these are restore discs for something which is really cool. Let's have a little look. Yeah, there you go. iMac G5. So nothing to do with the iMac that I've bought, but still. Now then, there is one hidden gem that I have not told you about. And that is the fact that all of this came with an Apple iSight webcam. And these things are worth an absolute bomb on their own anyway. And I've tested this out, I've had a conversation on MSN video call, believe it or not, with my girlfriend. And it's working flawlessly. It really is. And yeah, that MSN video call thing is working surprisingly well as well. But anyway, that's not what this video is about. I can't believe I got an eyesight, it's just crazy. But anyway, here we have the iMac. So, all I'm going to do now is get the tripod from under there and pop you on it and see if this thing boots up. So, I'm going to press that all-important power button. 3, 2, 1, go. We've got a bong. I can hear the hard disk spinning up already. Not too loud, actually. Not as loud as some iMac G3s that I've heard. Okay, looking for the operating system, and it's found OS 10. Now, it says on this note up here that it's 10.2, but we will soon see. I'm very sorry about the flickering on the screen, guys. That is obviously not the iMac. That's just due to the refresh rate of CRT displays not matching the camera. Okay, so the hard disk, the spinning sound of the hard disk isn't too irritating. It hasn't got that high-pitched whining sound that lots of old hard disks have. But the read-write head going across the disk is really loud. It's very, very ticky. And that's what you get with older hard disks. You know, you start up any old computer and it's just sitting down there clicking like mad compared to the new stuff. You know, I often forget when I've been used to using systems like my Mac Pro, you know, I often forget how loud these things can be. Okay, here we go. Whoa, Mac OS 10 server. Now this is cool. This'll be really fun to play around with. Mac OS 10 server, that is awesome. Okay, we've got the usual error up here. Obviously, we're not connected to the internet, so it isn't going to like that being a server-based OS. So we'll just click OK, and we should go straight to the desktop. Here we go. And we've got the dock. And we've got the menu bar. That is absolutely wicked. Okay, so there's not a lot you can do within this account. If I go up to the Apple menu up here, you'll be able to see that you've only got limited options. Yeah, the hard disk is quite loud. There you go, sleep and log out. oh, sorry about that, I've got a bit of a cold, but anyway. Yeah, sleep and log out are the only options you get. This is very limited. Let's go into applications. You'll be able to see how you scroll through the applications on here. So you can see all the applications here. We've got Safari and stuff like that, all your usual ones. Let's go to the next page. Here's the iSight utility. It's going to keep warning us about the internet. Here's the iSight utility because it came with an iSight camera. I hope you can see this well, guys. DVD player leads me to believe that this drive is a DVD drive, which will be nice. We've got QuickTime Windows Media Player. We've got quite a few cool things on here. The airport utility. We've got something called Clock. An old version of iTunes. Let's take a look in iTunes, actually. So this is iTunes, and we have a track in here called eBay. Let's take a listen to that.
A used pink bathrobe, a red
what the hell?
Mint snow globe, a Smurf TV tray I bought on eBay. My house is filled with this crap.
Okay. Now I know why people use these things as jukeboxes.
Shows up in bubble wrap most every day.
What? Oh my god.
I bought on eBay. Tell me why I need another pet rock. Tell me why I got that alpha lock.
Wow. The speakers in this thing are mind-blowing, or ear-blowing, I should say. Wow. Okay, nothing much interesting left in here. We've got a few random things. Internet Explorer, Real Player, Joy, AOL Instant Messenger, VLC, and we have MSN Messenger. Up here it looks like we've got Norton, I believe. Yeah, Norton Internet Security. But anyway, we can't do a lot on this particular account, so let's log out and let's pray that there's a normal account on this machine. Okay, here we have it, the bottom one. Please no password, please no password. 3, 2, 1. We're in. Sorted. Wicked. Now, you can see here that we've got a slightly more normal-looking desktop. Okay, let's go into about this Mac. This Mac is actually performing quite well. Okay, so we've got 256 megs of RAM and 500 megahertz PowerPC G3. Nice. Does what it says on the tin. Very, very nice. Coming down here then, we've got iPhoto, Microsoft Word. Let's just take a look if the entire suite is on here. We'll go into applications. God, I haven't used a version of OS X like this for... Whoa, Media Player. Check that out. Lovely. Where is it? Ah, cool. All-in-one printer utilities. What was I looking for again? Ah, yeah, Microsoft. Wicked, it's got the whole suite on here. I don't think this is 2004. This is pre-2004, the one before it. We'll soon find out with the startup screen now. It doesn't say 2004 on the folder, it says X. Yeah, this is the older version. Whoa, that loaded very quickly. Okay. There you have it, Microsoft Word. Wicked. That is really cool. This is a lovely machine, guys, and it's working fantastically. Let's have a look at the size of the hard drive. We're talking 30 gigs. Not bad. Not bad at all. We're getting about 27 gigs out of this thing. And with about 24 remaining as well. Okay. DVD player appears to be installed on this Mac, but let's see if it'll actually play a DVD. I just grabbed one off of my pile. Let's pop it in. I'm not much of a DVD person, really. One thing I like about this operating system is when you highlight something, it just becomes darker as if you're pushing it in, rather than that box come around the side of it. I do like that. Okay, so the DVD's appeared, and DVD player's opening. I think it's going to play it. It's playing it. Wicked. And it's doing everything with really, really good speed.
Sundays on Sky One is all about brand new Simpsons. Brand new Bart. New Marge. New Lisa.
Thank you.
And Maggie.
There must be some mistake.
Oh, and of course, brand new Homer.
This makes up for everything that's gone wrong in my life.
TV respects me. It left with me, not at me.
Brand new Simpsons. Sundays.
On Sky One.
Wicked. What an awesome machine. Okay. Oh, guys, one more thing that I'd like to point out as well. You know when you do Command Tab on a newer Mac, you get a box in the middle with all your applications listed? Well, on here, it highlights them in the dock. And when you hover over the app and press Q, it quits it, which is very cool. System prefs. This is the older system prefs. There's quite a lot in the other section down here. Not anything that interesting, to tell you the truth. But yeah, this Mac is really cool. Really, really cool. Obviously, I'll take Norton off of here because this is probably slowing it down quite badly. And we'll get this thing hooked up to the internet and whatnot. But, whoa. Very pleased with this. It's working really well. So I had a really nice working iMac and a really nice working iSight, all for £35. That is wicked. So yes, I am on the floor. Just got done testing the iMac and wow. I really love it. What are my plans? Right then. Well, I can't think of a use for the machine for me, but I don't want to sell it. I would say it would be nice to have as, you know, a bedside jukebox, but my Mac Pro is connected to my 5.1 surround sound in my room via optical Toslink, and I use the remote application on my phone to play music when I'm in bed, and that's an amazing sound system. So even though this has got really nice speakers and that, it would just be a bit of a waste of space if I was doing that. Quite nice to watch films on in bed. However, I've got two ways of doing that already. I can either watch it on the big projector screen up there, or my vintage TV at the bottom of my bed with the vintage video player hooked up to it. But we'll think of something. We'll think of something. It's very cool. I definitely don't want to sell it just yet. Think I'll keep it over summer and upgrade it. Yeah, I've just made that decision now. I'm going to keep this iMac over summer. And I'm going to max out the RAM. It's got 256 in it at the moment. I'll put a gig in it. It won't be that expensive probably to get 2 512 sticks for this thing. I'll change out the hard disk. Um, It's got a 30 gig in it at the moment. I'll change it out for an 80 gig that I've got lying around. I'll partition the 80 gig. I'll split it down the middle. Clone this hard disk into one partition, so I've still got all that fun 10.2 server stuff to play around with. And I'll install Tiger on the other partition, just to give that a blast. It'll be slow as hell, but we'll see what this thing can do under newish software. Also, I might put a 120 gig drive in there, not 100% sure, split it three ways, and get OS 9 on this thing as a clone from my PowerMac G3 over there. That would be really nice. Really nice. But yeah, I've got all these ideas swimming around in my head. I'll probably put an airport card in this thing. Don't need to change the optical drive, it's already got a DVD player in it. I'll buy a Pro Mouse for it because I don't want to carry on using stuff like this. I did have a white Pro Mouse, but I can't remember if I sold it to someone locally or something because I can't seem to find it anywhere. But anyway, it'll turn up. I want to get a graphite Pro Mouse anyway to match the keyboard. But yeah, fantastic machine. Really pleased with it. So before I rant on any longer, I'm going to plug my camera into my good old Mac Pro and get this video edited. And I've been asked to do more Mac Pro videos recently, so I'll see what I can do. There might be a Mac Pro upgrade video soon. You know, I've got tons of ideas swimming around in my head. I'm sick to death of the X1900 XT, I really am. That fan goes up pretty damn loud when you're trying to play a game. But anyway, that's completely off topic. I'm going to get this video edited now, and then as soon as this video is exporting, I'm going to play around with this. Very cool. Maybe listen to that eBay song again. Oh, and by the way, Final Cut 10, have you seen that? That looks pretty good. Anyway, off topic. I'm going to get this video edited and get it out to YouTube. So thanks for watching, guys, and I will see you next time.